All right, everyone, Alan here, episode, what are we at, 9?
I don't know, is this informed?
This is informed. I think this is episode 9, if you've been informed. KDE for all. So in CentOS 8, KDE was no longer offered. Red Hat no longer made KDE for CentOS 8. It was the default work environment for CentOS 7, at least with Flame, and it was decent. Nobody really complained. Then, like I said, starting with CentOS 8, Red Hat no longer made KDE, so Autodesk switched to Genome. Logical choice. Genome's fine, honestly. Window environment really doesn't matter much for me because like 99% of the time that I'm using a Linux machine, I'm actually in Flame. The problem is Teradici is fucked up, and I've been submitting bug reports for almost 2 years now regarding a particular thing with Teradici and Genome, which makes it, well, virtually unusable. But it's inconsistent, so it's not 100% unusable. It's just sometimes it's unusable, and sometimes it works great. There's no pattern. There's no remediation. It's incredibly random. Like, 1 minute it'll be working, and then you log out, and you log back in, and then it's not working. And there's nothing you could do. You could reboot the machine. You could, you know, do all of those things, log in, log out, reboot, and it won't fix itself. And then, like, you come back the next day, and it's working. So I don't want to use Genome. In fact, Teradici works great with Mate and with KDE, just not with Genome. Now, the good news is, starting with Rocky Linux 8.7, the Rocky Linux team is now maintaining KDE for Rocky Linux, so you can install it with just a few commands. I've already done that. If you guys are really interested, I'll give you the install commands. But for now, I just want to show you Flame works, and it works perfectly fine. So I'm going to log in to my workstation here, and you can see I have KDE Plasma chosen, and let's log in. So here we go. This is KDE. It's very much, very similar to what we had before, and it works just like everything would in Genome, except it's KDE. So Teradici works. And here's Flare 2024. Okay, this is Flare 2024. Okay, so let's just check out some clips that I have saved. These are like kind of test clips I use for a bunch of the different things we have here in the studio. But you can see it's playing back. And if I go into batch, let's just add a couple clips into batch. And all the hotkeys work. Got our delete. Alt-Tab acts slightly different. Instead of the Genome overview, this is the KDE overview. It's fine though, it works, no problem. And what else? This is the Windows key, or the super key, that works. So yeah, here we go, Flame on KDE. I think it's something that Autodesk should support natively, given the issues with Teradici, which are incredibly frustrating and problematic, but we're gonna move forward with this. KDE for all, you've been burned. Or no, you've been informed. I think episode 9.